Let's see how you select replenishment system for items or SKUs in Business Central. Going into the item card, we have the tab replenishment system down here, replenishment, and we have the replenishment system where you can select how to replenish this item. This means when you have calculated the quantity you need, at what date you need it, you need to define the replenishment system to figure out how you replenish it. And you can select here from purchase, production order or assembly, and in the stock keeping unit card you could also add transfer. So if it's a purchase item, the first one, the fields down here on the purchase will need to be filled in. I will run through those in another video. If it's a production item, you fill in all the fields on the right hand side for production, and if it's an assembly item, you fill in the assembly fields. So basically, purchase items is of course item you are buying from a vendor. Production items is item you're producing where you have routing and bill of material. And assembly items is like simple production items that you just are assembling either to stock or to sales order directly, meaning just taking components and maybe some resource time. So it's a simple way of using production, and it's even more tied into sales order than the production is. If you go to the stock keeping unit, the list of SKUs, meaning you can have one SKU per item per location. So if I'm filtering here on item 1000, I can see I have two SKUs. One is for location symbol 1. If there's a SKU on a location, the planning will take the SKU card first and not the item card. If there's not a SKU, it will take information from the item card. So in this case, if I plan on symbol 1 or warehouse 1, it will take one of those SKU. If I plan on symbol 2, or warehouse 2 or another location, it will take the field from the item card. So basically on the first SKU it says that it's a production item, meaning when I'm requiring or replenishing this item on location symbol 1, I will have to produce it. Whereas if I go into the SKU card for warehouse 1 and I scroll down to my replenishment system, I can see this is a transfer item and it takes 1 week, meaning I replenish it on the location warehouse 1 by moving it from my location symbol 1. So this is the way I want the system automatically to calculate how to replenish the warehouse 1 location for this item. I'll run through the fields in another video.